Good day to all my Form 5 students. So today we are going to start on Chapter 3, Form 5, Redox Reaction. So I hope before you look at teacher's video, I hope you have done page 103 till 111. Page 103 until 111. Page 111 of this module so that you can follow teacher's video or teacher's lesson for today. Okay, so now, so teacher have written the chapter, name of the chapter, and also the page that we are going to discuss for today. Okay, so this is a new chapter called Redox Reaction. So what is the meaning? So before we start, you have to know that redox reaction actually talks about some of the chemical reactions that you are very, very familiar with. For instance, displacement of metal, chapter 6, electrochemistry, voltaic cell, and chapter 3, form 4, magnesium oxide. Okay, empirical, the way to determine, the method to determine empirical formula of magnesium oxide will come into the chapter again. So, if you're not very sure about the three subtopics that I've told you, it is advisable for you all to go back and have a look at those subtopics in that related chapters before you continue this video. Okay, so now let's start. Now, before we start in the, when we are starting this chapter, of course, we are going to look at the definition of redox reaction. Okay, now for your further information, you should know that redox comes from two words, which is reduction and oxidation. So, R-E-D-N-O-X, redox reaction. So, redox reaction is actually a combination of two processes called oxidation and reduction. Thus, redox reaction is a process where oxidation and reduction happens simultaneously. Maksudnya pada waktu yang, pada masa yang sama. So that means if you want to label a certain reaction as redox reaction, you must make sure that the reaction has a reaction called reduction and oxidation happening at the same time. There are some processes, not all chemical processes are redox reaction. Some of the reaction processes are not chemical reactions, but they are not redox reactions. Okay, so after teacher explained about oxidation, reduction and all that, teacher will give you few examples of reactions which are not redox reactions. Okay, so now you already know the definition of redox reaction. Reduction and oxidation happen simultaneously. Okay, simultaneously. Okay, pada masa yang sama, or you can even use the word same time. Alright, now let's go to in what ways oxidation and reduction can be defined. Okay, so now please remember when you're going through this chapter, I want you to take oxidation and reduction like black and white. They're totally opposite from each other. Okay, so there are few concepts for you to explain oxidation and reduction. So oxidation is where you gain oxygen, here lose oxygen. Did you write properly? Here you lose hydrogen and you gain hydrogen. Don't worry, I will explain more on this when we are looking at few examples. Okay, third is you oxidation is a process where lose electrons, here gain electrons. Okay, here you can say increase in oxidation number, here losing or decrease in oxidation number. Okay, so now that is the reason why it's better for you to have this module, page 103. Teacher talking about page 103. So this is what we have written here. Okay, now so oxidation is a process where when the substance gains oxygen, it is said to go through oxidation. Now see, so you see how teacher relate this. Okay, when a substance loses electron, that substance is said to go through oxidation. When a substance increases the oxidation number, it is said to go through, oxidation. Vice versa, when a substance loses oxygen, that means if we say that the substance has gone through reduction. When a substance gains electron, we say that the substance has gone through reduction. So can you see how we relate oxidation reduction? Now, so when you analyze this, can you see that oxidation reduction is like black and white, positive, negative? Okay, so that is the reason why if you manage to remember any of these, mainly you like about reduction, you just try to remember everything about reduction. Even in exam, they ask about oxidation, no problem, you can remember. Why? Because you know the concept. Reduction is totally opposite from oxygen. Okay, so that's how you remember. Alright, now let's go to few definitions. Now, why these definitions are important? Because when we are discussing this, all these definitions will come into the picture. So that's why it's important for you all to know these definitions before we start explaining the examples. Okay, now so let's go to oxidizing agent. So oxidizing agent, if you look at page 103, oxidizing agent is substance that does two things, oxidizes other substance, but the sad thing is it goes through reduction. Meaning, oxidizing agent is a substance that helps other substance to go through oxidation. But unfortunately, it goes through reduction. That means it helps other people. For instance, when I'm giving you money, when I give you money, you are gaining money. But unfortunately, my pocket is being empty, correct? So the same concept you apply here. So oxidizing agent helps other substance to go through oxidation, but it goes through reduction. Now, if you are smart enough, you should be able to write down the definition for reducing agent. Substance that, try to write down, substance that, it does two things, reduces other substances, but it goes through oxidation. Hope you can see this. Okay, so please refer to page 103. Okay, so definition for reducing agent is substance. Can you see they are vice versa? Now you can see the picture already. You can see their pattern already. Oxidation and reduction are total vice versa from each other. They are like black and white, positive, negative. Okay, so now, so definition for reducing agent, substance that reduces other substances, but it goes through oxidation itself. Okay, can you see that is total opposite from this? Okay, so that is the reason why definition, before we run through example 1 and example 1-2, it's important for you to define the meaning of redox reaction. You must know how oxidation and reduction is explained. Third and fourth, define oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Okay, now so let's go to one example. I know even now you're not very sure, but when teacher explain about the examples, you can roughly know how does oxidation and reduction is explained using one chemical reaction. Okay, now so let's look at this. Okay, now so magnesium reacts with copper 2 oxide to produce magnesium oxide and copper. Now, teacher, I am going to define this as oxidation reduction. Okay, now see, but one thing, when you're explaining this process as a redox reaction, you must come back to here. When you're explaining, you must come back to here. But unfortunately, when you are explaining this reaction, there are few things that you can't explain. For instance, you cannot use concept number 2, lose hydrogen and gain hydrogen. Why? Because you don't see hydrogen here. Am I right? So since you don't use or see hydrogen here, it is not suitable for you to use the word, oh, magnesium loses hydrogen, copper oxide loses hydrogen or something like that. Why? It is not suitable. Same goes here. This example. Do you see any oxygen here? No. So that is the reason why try not to know. Better don't use the word gain oxygen or lose oxygen. Why? That explanation won't be suitable. Right, now let's go to here. Okay, now so looking at this, can you see magnesium has gained? Please look at before and after the arrow. Magnesium has gained oxygen. So we can say that, can you see who goes through oxidation? You can say magnesium goes through oxidation, vice versa. Copper 2 oxide goes through reduction. Can you see? You can just write down in a form of sentence just by looking at this table. Okay, point 1. Point 2. Now, why do you say magnesium has gone through oxidation? Gains oxygen. See, that's why oxygen. Loses oxygen. Okay, so now, so how am I going to make all them, join all them together? Magnesium goes through oxidation because it gains oxygen atom. Copper 2 oxide goes through reduction because it loses oxygen. Can you see how we combine them? Okay. Now, second is, you can say, now what happens is if we make it into ionic equation, this is actually what happens to magnesium. Magnesium 2 electron to become magnesium 2 plus. Copper 2 ion actually has gained electron to become copper metal. If you look at the ionic form of way of explaining. Now, if this happens, can we further strengthen our explanation that magnesium atom lose electron to increase oxidation number? Is that correct? From Mg0 has gone to Mg2+. Why it managed to go from 0 to 2+? Because our friend has given electron. Can you see? That's the reason why. So magnesium goes through oxidation by losing electron and increasing the oxidation number. Okay, now can we write down for copper 2 oxide? Copper 2 oxide, or you can write, I think this one we better write as copper 2 ion. Sorry, yeah. Because the person who's involved here is copper 2 ion. Okay, so now, so gains electron to reduce is oxidation number. Okay, so is that valid? When you look at the ionic equation, can you see that is valid? Why? Because it has gained electron, 2 electrons in fact, to become copper atom. Now, looking at this, can you identify who's the oxidizing agent, who's the reducing agent? Okay, so we can say that magnesium oxidation goes through oxidation. So magnesium is reducing agent. Reduction is oxidizing agent. Okay, oxidizing agent. Now see, so let's look at, recap on how we are going to explain this chemical equation, and we are going to confirm that this is indeed a redox reaction. Why this is a redox reaction? Why teacher managed to explain oxidation and reduction at the same time. Can you see? I managed to explain oxidation and reduction at the same time. Now, for instance, this was supposed, you're supposed to write copper 2 ion. Why? Oxygen is just transferred here and there, but the actual fellow who's actually going through oxidation reduction is the copper 2 ion. Okay, now, so let's go to, now we are going to combine all these dalam beberapa ayat in a few sentences, okay? Magnesium goes through oxidation because it gains oxygen. Magnesium goes through oxidation because it loses electron and gains oxidation number. Thus, magnesium is the reducing agent. Can you see how you can tie up all this together in one sentence? Okay, now, so let's look at here. Copper 2 ion goes through reduction because it loses oxygen. Copper 2 ion goes through reduction by gaining electron and reducing oxidation number. Thus, copper 2 ion is oxidizing agent. Can you see? So, you can write like this, but don't write in a form of, okay, you can write all this as like a rangka for your essay question. If this chapter comes on for essay question, don't waste it, because one of the easiest chapter to answer when it comes to essay question. Okay, but all you have to, what you do, just do like this and you just tie up all these key points into sentences. Easy. Alright, now let's go to example number 2. Again, teacher highlighting, you cannot use point number 1, gaining and losing oxygen. Why? Because you don't see any oxygen here. So it will be wrong if you use the word oxygen. So the most suitable word for you to write down here is actually gaining or losing hydrogen. Okay, so let's start. So by the time, I want you to refer to page 104. Please refer to page 104 when teacher explaining this. Okay, now, so looking at this, by now, after looking up, hearing teacher explaining about this, you can roughly know, okay, about this, Okay, now, so let's go to roughly, can you determine who goes through oxidation? Now, if you want to look at someone goes through oxidation, look at who has lost hydrogen. Can you see sulfur? Okay, so you can say hydrogen sulfide has gone through oxidation. Who goes through reduction? Chlorine goes through reduction. Okay, now, so what happens is, second is why you're telling hydrogen sulfide goes through oxidation? Lose hydrogen, gain hydrogen. Okay, 2 become sulfur, 2 become hydrogen chloride. You can even write like that. Okay, now, so here, I think it's better to, because this chapter actually does not explain about transfer of electron like how teacher explained here. So never mind, we just concentrate on this example given. Now let's go to who. That means you can say hydrogen sulfide goes through oxidation. Hydrogen sulfide loses hydrogen to form sulfur atom. Chlorine goes through reduction. Chlorine gains hydrogen to form hydrogen chloride. So, in this case, who do you think is reducing agent and oxidizing agent? So, another tips, any substance that goes through oxidation will be reducing agent. Easy. Can you see? Any substance goes through oxidation is considered as reducing agent. Look here. Reduces other substance but goes through oxidation. Can you see? So that is the reason why. Very easy. When teacher asks you who's there, when you do the table like this, can you see? Just crisscross. I don't think so. It's too much to ask for. You just crisscross. Reducing agent, oxidizing agent. Okay? Easy. Okay. So if that's the case, here, oxidizing agent. Okay? So you can tie up all these into few sentences. Hydrogen sulfide goes through oxidation because loses hydrogen. Hydrogen sulfide loses hydrogen to form sulfur atom. So hydrogen sulfide is the reducing agent. Chlorine goes through reduction. Why? Because chlorine gains hydrogen. Chlorine goes through reduction to gain hydrogen and form hydrogen chloride. And chlorine is the oxidizing agent. So you just swap like this. Just make an X. Okay. So now, so let's go to example on page 105. Give me 2 seconds. Let me write this off. Okay, so now please look at page 105. Okay, so please look at page 105. Teacher going to explain example 1 and example 2. Okay, now 2 sodium reacts with chlorine to produce sodium chloride. Okay, now here it is important for you to identify few things before we start, which is you write down the ionic equation. Okay, so now, so let's build the tables. It's important for you to explain all the time using a table. It's important. Why? Because easy to understand. Alright, so now, so let's go to how are we going to explain this reaction where sodium atom reacts with chlorine to produce sodium chloride. Again, please look at page 105. I hope you have done the answers, okay, for this. Now let's explain oxidation and reduction. Okay class, who do you think has gone through oxidation just by looking at this? But please remember, can you use concept number 1? Oh, sodium goes through oxidation because it has gained oxygen. Not suitable. Second, can you use explanation number 2? You can't, because you can't see any hydrogen present here, correct? So that is the reason why concept 1 and concept 2 is out of question. You cannot use concept 1, concept 2. So please remember, when you're explaining oxidation reduction, please look at the how suitable is the concept that you're supposed to use. Alright, so now let's go to oxidation. Now see, roughly when you look at this, sodium has lost electron to become sodium ion. So sodium atom goes through oxidation, chlorine goes through reduction. Now why? Loses electron, increase oxidation number. Can you see teacher writing this both together? Why? Because they are like one package already. The moment you say loses electron, confirm you can explain about increase in oxidation number. Can you see the oxidation number from 0 increase to positive 1? Look at chlorine. Oxidation number from 0 has reduced to negative 1. So that is the reason why loses electron, increase oxidation number. So now you can happily write for chlorine. So what did I tell you? They are vice versa. Okay. So gain electron, decrease oxidation number. Is that correct? So you can refer to here. Okay. Now in that case, please identify oxidizing and reducing agent. Very simple. Take this right here. Reducing agent, this color you write here, oxidizing agent. Okay, so now let's tie up all this together in few sentences. Okay, now so sodium atom goes through oxidation. Okay, now so sodium atom goes through oxidation, chlorine goes through reduction. Sodium atom goes through oxidation, because it loses electron and increases or gains in oxidation number. Chlorine goes through reduction because it has gained electron and reduces in oxidation number. Okay, can you see? And now you explain the third sentence. Sodium is the reducing agent. Chlorine is the oxidizing agent. So, 4 hingga 3 ayat. You can get marks for your essay question already. Alright? Now, so let's continue to the next example. Magnesium. Okay, so now, hopefully majority of you all can remember what reaction is this. Okay, try to remember, this is actually a displacement reaction. Just for further information, displacement reaction is actually a subtopic that you learn in chapter 6, form 4, electrochemistry, where a more electropositive metal displaces a least electropositive metal from the salt solution. Magnesium, more electropositive, displaces copper 2 ion from the salt solution. Okay, so now, before that, let's look at the ionic state of the magnesium and the copper 2. Okay, so magnesium loses 2 electrons to become magnesium ion. Copper ion loses, receives 2 electrons to become copper. Okay, so hope you can understand this. Why? Because you are exposed to this, how to write the half ionic equation when you are doing last year's chapter electrochemistry. So you should know already. Okay, now, so let's continue on the analysis. Now, oxidation, reduction. Okay, just write like this. Okay, now, so looking at this, can you identify who has gone through oxidation? So, magnesium has gone through oxidation, copper 2 ion has gone through reduction. Can you see how teacher writing? Not copper 2 sulfate, I'm writing the ion involved. Why? Because when you write down the ionic equation, sulfate is just pembawa ion saja. Okay, so now, so we are interested in the ion that actually has changed oxidation numbers here and there. They will be the hero and heroine of the story. Right? Okay, now, so why do you think magnesium goes through oxidation? Lose electron, gain oxidation number, gain electron, lose oxidation number. Don't say lose, I think better don't say lose. Decrease, increase. Let's say decrease or increase in oxidation number. Now, can you determine who is the reducing agent? Who's the oxidizing agent? That's why it's important for you to write the table like this. When you write table like this, it's very easy. Just swap. Reducing agent, oxidizing agent. Okay, so now, so let's tie up all this together. Magnesium goes through oxidation. Copper 2 ion goes through reduction. What happens? Magnesium loses electron and increases oxidation number. That's what you see here. Magnesium loses 2 electron to become magnesium 2 plus ion. Copper 2 ion gain electron, receive electron to reduce the oxidation number. So, copper 2 ion, that's no wonder, goes through reduction. Now, in that case, magnesium labeled as reducing agent. Copper 2 ion is the oxidizing agent. Okay, so now, so I hope you can understand. Let's continue to page 105. Okay, sorry, page 106. Teacher will explain page 106 in next video.